Welcome to Robert C. Byrd High School. This is RCB basketball. And ladies and gentlemen, it's the postseason. It's arrived here at the Byrd Cage. This is a win-or-go-home game. At least we think it is. It's hard to tell, Jonathan, with all the new playoff scenarios. But this is the first round of the sectional game, and the winner moves on. The loser goes to the next sport.
Yeah, it's always hard to tell in high school basketball. You want to say it's win or go home, but you never really know because you could play again. You may not play again. You probably will play again. But a big one no matter what here tonight inside the Birdcage.
I was all prepared last week to offer the girls basketball team condolences on a good season. I thought it had ended with their loss at Elkins, but I got to school the next day and Coach Noble informed me that, no, they are going to play this week in the regional championship. At least we think it's the regional. RCB comes in at 9-12, Elkins 5-17 overall. Robert C. Byrd did play Elkins here at home earlier this year. They won. They beat Elkins. They were supposed to play two games, but one of those games was canceled by the snow that we had there in mid-January. So the two teams are going to lace it up tonight with the right to move on to the next step of the playoffs. Just about set to go here at the Birdcage. As we said, light crowd on hand tonight, and that's what we've seen, you know, in the past few years. The crowds have been dwindling. Elkins has got to come a long way. That's about an hour's drive, and apparently there's a lot of homework assignments going on for the RCB student body tonight.
Yeah, it'll be quite of an adjustment, especially, you know, just the contrary from the last home game Byrd played against Bridgeport. You know, it was probably the crowdest that we had seen the gymnasium all year, and now you're coming in what is a bigger game, you know, win or go home scenario, and, you know, there's not a whole lot of student section. So we'll see how that plays out here this evening.
Our producer tonight, as always, David Oliverio, doing a fine job for us. We'll keep it right here as we listen to the national anthem as we honor America.
If everybody could please rise, and gentlemen, remove your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
And now for your home standing, Robert C. Byrd Flying Eagles at guard. number 11, Anthony Marbello. And an underdog, 5'10", 160-pound sophomore, number 12, Logan Boyce. At center, 6'3", 160-pound sophomore, number 1, Carson Beck. At forward, a 6'1", 150-pound sophomore, number 2, Manny Holmes. At another forward, a 6'1", 140-pound sophomore, number 3, Riley Dickerson. And the rest of the Flying Eagles, Robert Seabrook's head coach, assisted by Justin Logan, Willie Chutters, is the position, assisted by Nate King and Madison Stern. Dougie Lakefield is the manager.
So there are the starting lineups for Robert C. Byrd and Elkins. Elkins wearing orange uniforms tonight. I kind of like the orange. Robert C. Byrd in their traditional home white uniforms.
Very
about ready to tip things up.
Very Halloweenish.
Yes.
For Elkins.
And here's Carson Bennett. He's going to tip it back towards the, well, towards their basket, but it's going to go out of bounds. And it will be Elkins' ball. And immediately, Robert C. Byrd's going to come out in full court, man-to-man pressure.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see how Elkins handles this pressure here tonight
right
by the Flying Eagles.
And it actually may be a good idea that Elkins sees this pressure to start out with, instead of it's off of a made basket.
Yeah, and now they actually switched the call. So they're going to say it was, I think the official said he just pointed the wrong way.
Yeah.
It should have been white ball. So
Robert C. Byrd's going to inbound underneath their own basket. They throw the ball into Barbario. And he'll set things up for the Eagle offense. High screen by Bennett. Off the boys. He'll look at a three. He'll take it. Off the mark to the right, rebound Dickerson. The ref's in my way. He puts a shot back up, can't get it to go, and Griffin Boggs controls for the Tigers.
Yeah, good look by Boyce, and then a good rebound by Riley Dickerson. Just couldn't get the put back to go.
Here's a three by Holland, no good, and Holmes comes down for rebound. I want to welcome in all those around the area listening to the broadcast tonight. Thank you for joining us. Here's a deflection by number 4, Heinzman. For the Tigers, once again in control of possession. Here's a three long by Heinzman. That's Dylan Heinzman. And it's going to go off a Robert C. Byrd player. It's going to stay with the Eagles.
Offensively, we'll see Robert C. Byrd. They've struggled somewhat this year against the zone, and that's primarily what Elkins has played so far. And they've got, Robert C. Byrd's gotten two good looks early, but they've been pretty far shots away from the basket. So we'll see if Robert C. Byrd can somewhat attack this zone better here. There's an ex-offensive possession.
Here's a nice inbounds pass and a bucket for number 43, Holland, off that inbounds pass itself. Yeah, you'd like to see Robert C. Byrd get some layups, some shots in the paint. And here's a tip ball, and they're going to say it was a tip, and it's going to be a backcourt.
Yeah, it sure did look like it got tipped, and I even think Elkins is number 4, kind of put his hand up like he got a piece of it. But however, that's going to be the second turnover here in this first quarter for the Flying Eagles.
He may have tipped it, but they're not going to call it, of course. Wanless gets the ball on the wing. Boggs will drive it now. Here's another three out of the corner. It's good for Heinzman. So a quick 5-0 sprint out for the Tigers, the visiting Tigers, all the way from Elkins. Deep down in Randolph County. Shouldn't say too deep. But anywhere you go in Randolph County is obviously deep sometimes. Here's Boyce on a drive. Kicks it out to Barbario. He'll set his feet. Can't get it to go. That's long. Body's on the floor. Rebound taken by Holland. And Holland's a football player in his spare time, obviously, by the looks.
Yeah, no penetration right now by this Flying Eagles offense.
No. Boggs loses the ball. Bryce comes up with it. He'll push it. Dickerson ahead. He's going to drive in, and he's going to get the bucket and the foul. So a nice move by Dickerson. His first two of the night, and Robert C. Bird's first two of the night. Foul's going to be on number five, Levi Wanless, his first. So that was a good job of watching Dickerson go straight to the bucket that time. No hesitation.
Yeah, and again, I think Robert C. Bird, they're such a fast-paced team, and Coach Lucas and his coaching staff, they want to push the ball and play fast. And that's a great example of getting the ball, the rebound, and going coast-to-coast and scoring before the defense gets set.
Dickerson misses the first one, but Boyce comes up with the rebound, and he puts it back in for the 2 points. Boggs at half court, and it's going to be off Dickerson. Good job pressuring the ball there. Wanless at the controls. He's guarded by Holmes. Off to Holland. Back to Heinzman. Here's Boggs on a drive. Kind of pushes off. No call. Probably a good play, and he gets the two. Nice drive and layup by Boggs there. Here's Holmes looking at a three. Off to Boyce. Boyce will get a little bit of penetration. Shot's long, and it's tipped out of bounds by the Tigers. Number two, Lucas D'Angelo, just couldn't control the ball there.
Yeah, Boggs is undoubtedly a little bit of a do-everything for the Elkins Tigers. He's got one rebound, one assist, and 2 points in this ball game, so he's leaving his mark so far early on.
Yeah. 7-4, the Tigers in control here. 5:01 to go in the first quarter. Here's an inside pass. Holmes can't handle it. Gives it back to Dickerson. He'll penetrate, drive, shot short, rebound Bennett. Nice jumps there, nice ups there. But he can't control it. Down court to the Tigers. D'Angelo waiting for the rest of his den to come. Tigers' den.
And that was a good rebound by Bennett. It just wasn't quite strong enough to go back up.
Yeah.
Lost it on the way back up.
And that's where we say the Eagles have got to get in the weight room this year. Got to get stronger up top. And now we're going to have a foul. It's going to be on Griffin Boggs, his first. It's going to be team second.
Yeah, now you're going to call over the back. And that was a good box out there by Anthony Barbario, the shortest player on the court, boxing out Griffin Boggs, the tallest player on the court.
Yeah. So it can be done. Barbario will give it off to Holmes. Holmes to Boyce. Over to Dickerson. They're looking inside now. Still can't get anything. Elkins has packed that zone in tight. Now Holmes tries a three straight away, and it's good. So Holmes' first bucket of the night is a three-pointer, and we're knotted at seven.
And a good. That was a good baseline drive by Boyce. Good kick out to find Holmes for the wide-open three, and good in and out.
They had more movement there. A three is no good by Heinzman. Here's Anthony Barbario driving back down court, and he'll draw the foul, and he'll go to the line. That foul's going to be against number two, Lucas D'Angelo, I believe, his first. Team third, so Barbario will get two free throws. A few students from the Elkins student body there in the crowd tonight made the journey up. Barbario hits the first one. Set for the second one. That's RCB's first lead of the night, 8-7. Early, though. Second shot's up, and it's good. Tigers looking to break that press, and they do fairly easily. Just good ball movement by the Tigers.
You know, that was a good job by Elkins of just being patient. Not, you know, that press is not always there to force turnovers, but somewhat to speed up the offensive team. And Elkins did a good job of being under control and taking their time.
They have Griffin Boggs on the post. Not sure why they didn't get it to him earlier. He kicks it out. Has it back now. Puts the ball on the floor and drives. Nothing doing. Here is Holland with a three. Left side is good. So the big man can shoot.
And that was all predicated off of Boggs with the penetration and kicking out to Holland.
Now they get it to Carson Bennett in the post. A little turnaround, spin move, hook, bank shot is good for Carson Bennett.
And that's a good sign for the Flying Eagles because Carson Bennett, when he can get it in there and had making a great move like that and finishing with points, it's good for the Flying Eagles.
Good pressure applied by the Flying Eagles. Knocked out of bounds by Holmes, so the Eagles will retain possession. Heinzman, the trigger man, he gets it in to Wanless. Wanless will work right side, guarded by Boyce. Runs into a screen, checked by Holmes. Crowd wants a foul, and they're finally going to get one, but not the one they thought they were going to get. It's going to go on number two. His first, and that is the first team foul for the Flying Eagles tonight.
Yeah, it looked like they got Manny reaching there at the very end. Played pretty good defense until he reached there.
Yeah. Here is Griffin, inbounds, turnaround, jump shot, no good. Rebound, Dickinson, they're pushing now. Barbario down court. Tigers get back down quickly, though. And now they find Carson Bennett on a nice delayed secondary break, and he's going to be fouled, and he's going to go to the line for two shots. Foul's going to go on Holland, his first, team fourth. Carson Bennett, not a free throw shooter, not somebody we've seen at the free throw line much this year, but he knocks that first one down. And you would think that Coach Lucas would like to see Connor at the line more.
Well, yeah, if you can get somewhat of an inside presence, you know, we talked about how undersized this Eagles team has been all year, but Carson Bennett's got some size and length, and if he can be a presence inside, that's only going to open things out on the perimeter as well, because down the stretch, the Eagles have shot the three really, really well.
Yeah. I apologize, I called him Connor, but it is Carson Bennett. He's set for the second one. It's up, and this rolls around and in the bucket. Thirteen-10, 2:11 to go in the first quarter. Robert C. Byrd, again, man-to-man, full-court pressure. Now they'll double-team, and they throw it right into the arms of Cam Newsom. He'll race down floor. He's going to get fouled and make the bucket. So a nice job by Newsom right off the bat. Foul's going to be on number two, Lucas D'Angelo. That's his second, and the team fifth of the first quarter. And if you're going to foul there, you got to foul him and make sure he doesn't make the shot.
I think they actually called that on Wanless. Yeah, looked like they called that on Wanless.
Okay, so that is the first one on, or the second one on. Second one on Wanless. Still the 15 foul.
The score is right. It's 15.
I didn't hear that. All right, so interpretation here. We thought Carson Bennett hit two free throws. He was one out of two.
Which he did hit two free throws. However, one happened to end up being a lane violation.
And that will not count against him. So technically, he's one for one. So it's as if that free throw never counted. So it's 14-10, at least we think. And the Tigers have the ball in the form of Aaron Friedman, probably the smallest kid on the floor right now, working against pressure. And nice try to trap by Chris, I should say, didn't want to be called Chris, Junior Smith there, but he doesn't get the hands off the arm, and he commits the foul, his first, team second. 1:41 to go, 14-10, Flying Eagles on top. And we do have a little bit of a student section now. They were arriving late. They're fashionably late.
Yeah, fashionably late, just like the class.
Yeah. Here's Friedman with the drive. He'll kick it out to Boggs. Adam Lambert, another football player, trying to set a screen. And here's a three out of the corner for Griffin Boggs. No good. Smith with the rebound. He'll push forward. And a good job by Smith pushing the ball there. But he stayed on the right side of the court. And he's got to get to the middle there.
Yeah, really good job there by you know, most point guards, especially being a freshman, would want to take that right to the basket.
Yeah.
And he did a good job of pushing it, but then resetting it when he realized he had nothing there.
My point being that if he'd have got to the middle of the floor, he might have had more options too. But, yes, a good job for him to just hold on to it and not force it. Here's Boyce with his second three-point try of the possession, and this one is good, his first three of the night. 17-10, Eagles on top. 30 seconds to go in the first quarter here. Nice pass by Boggs, and another nice pass by, I should say, a nice pass by Holland to Boggs, and Boggs made that next pass to Lambert. Lambert, he put the two in. Here's another three by Boyce. It's good. So I'm falling behind on scoring here. I'm caught up now. 20-12 with that three-pointer by Boyce. So the Eagles on top, 20-12. We'll be back with the second quarter after these messages. Inside the birdcage on an unseasonably warm night, Jonathan. But it's going to get colder tomorrow night.
Yeah. 60 today, 30 tomorrow.
It's still basketball season.
Who knows what it'll be Thursday or Friday.
And we should mention Friday, if the Eagles win, or the Tigers win for that matter, they will be playing at the higher seed. So if the Eagles win, they'll play Friday. If Liberty wins, they'll play at Liberty. If Lincoln wins tonight, then they will be playing here. Lincoln will be playing here because Robert C. Byrd is a two seed. Liberty is the one seed. We're the two seed. Elkins the three seed, and Lincoln is the four seed. That's how it shook out in the section this year. So Friedman's going to stay in there for the Tigers and run things. Here's a pass inside to Lambert in the post, loses it out of bounds, but it's going to stay with the Tigers. Inbounds goes to Friedman. He's checked by Barbario. Holland thinking about a cross-court pass to Boggs, but decides against it. Boggs with the ball, checked by Boyce.
Flying Eagles doing a really good job defensively this possession.
And there's Friedman with a three off the bench. So they left him open. He nailed the shot. Cuts the lead to five, 20-15. 7 minutes remaining. Here's a pass inside to Bennett. He'll pivot, look to Newson. He'll kick it over to Barbario. He tries to get it into Bennett. Can't. And now we have a scramble on the ball. Good hustle by both teams. And it's going to be a jump ball. It's going to stay with the Eagles.
Yeah, good hustle there by Cam Newson to get control of that ball. It was him and four other Tigers, and he held on for dear life.
And that's where if Carson can develop a little bit of upper body strength in his arms and his shoulders and his chest next year, he'll be able to hold on to that ball and wrestle it away from the defender. Here is a three by Manny Holmes off the bound. Rebound Holland for the Tigers. Obviously, they're doing a good job in their man-to-man defense. Here is Boggs with a drive. Awkward shot. Can't get it to go. Rebound Bennett. They'll push it down quickly. Here's Holmes going to try a three out of the corner. Sets himself. No good. Rebound Tigers. Here is Heinzman driving down, and he's going to draw the foul. So good job by, or I should say that's Friedman. Good job by Friedman pressing the action, and he's going to draw the foul.
Yeah, Elkins giving Robert Seabird a little taste of their own medicine, getting it out of the basket and going and trying to score before the defense gets set.
Foul's going to be on Barbario, his first, team first, of the second quarter. First shot by Heinzman, or I should say Friedman, I'm sorry, he's no good, off the back of the rim. He'll get the second. Caleb Ray has checked in for the Tigers. And Friedman makes the second shot. Now, Elkins in a little bit of a man-to-man pressure. Nice move by Nusson. Puts the bucket in.
Yeah, Nusson weaving through the defense there to get an easy layup.
Looked like he almost was going to walk, and then he flipped the ball up at the last moment to make it good. Here's good defense by Barbario, and he had his hand in the passing lane where all good coaches teach their players to have that hand, and he was able to get a hand on it and deflect it. .5:25 to go, 22-16, 6-point margin for the Flying Eagles. Opening round of sectional play here at the Birdcage. Now Lambert's going to put the ball on the floor. Can't get anywhere. Score update from Lincoln, Liberty in that game. In the second quarter, Lincoln is ahead of Liberty 19-10.
A little bit of a shocker there.
Yeah. Foul's going to be on Barbario, his second, team second, so he picks up two quick ones.
Junior Smith set the check in for Barbario, I would imagine.
Yeah. And Griffin Boggs at the line makes the first one. He'll get the second one here. Up and no good. Rebound Cam Nusson, or I should say Sin Nusson, and now Cam Nusson loses the ball. Tigers regain possession and they'll hold things up.
Yeah, fourth turnover in this contest for the Flying Eagles. Meanwhile, Elkins only has one turnover.
Here's Heinzman with penetration. He'll kick it out to Friedman. No good on the three. Back down court to Sin Nusson. He'll take the ball in, and he's going to draw a foul. Elkins' bench wanted a charge, but it's going to be a block. It's going to go against number 44, Aiden Lambert, his first, team first. A little bit of sweat on the floor. So Sin Nusson will be at the line for two shots. First one's up, and it's good. So it was hard for us to see at that angle. I couldn't really tell. That action moves real quick, and you've got to be really close if you want to really know exactly what the call is. Of course, you know, my definition of being set is probably different from what others are.
Elkins wanted the charge.
Yeah.
Robert C. Byrd wanted the block.
Yeah.
Robert C. Byrd's happy right for right now.
That's how it goes. Sincere misses the second shot, but they do get the rebound. Boyce tries a mid-range jumper, can't get it to go, and now they're going to call Riley Dickerson over the back. That'll be his first, team third.
Yeah, he tried to go up and get it over Aiden Lambert. Lambert did a good job that time of boxing out Dickerson to get the over-the-back call.
Here's a good job to break the press by the Eagles, or I should say the Tigers. They get down there and they lose the ball. And now here's Boyce back up floor. He loses the ball, so a little bit of sloppy play right now. And Holland will settle things down for the Tigers, and he'll bring it up floor. Here's a nifty move by Friedman, driving to the bucket. Loses the ball out of bounds. Looked like there might have been some contact, but the ball definitely came out of his hands. So the ball go back to the Eagles. Here's pressure by Elkins, and Robert C. Byrd breaks it, but from behind, number three, Caleb Ray steals the ball, but he steps on the end line. So good job by Elkins there to put a little pressure on Robert C. Byrd, try to beat him at their own game.
Yeah, and the sloppy play has continued. We've had now back-to-back-to-back-to-back turnovers.
And here's a nifty inbounds pass right to Cam Newson. Can't get it to go. Junior Smith on the rebound, falling away. His shot is no good, and the Tigers rebound.
Yeah, a couple good looks there.
Yeah.
By the Flying Eagles, just couldn't get the ball to fall.
Here's Friedman, or I should say Lambert, the ball in the post. He loses it, and the Eagles pick it up. Down court to Smith. He'll miss the layup. He was bothered by the defender there, but Boyce gets the rebound. And he gets fouled on the putback. So that's the first on Ray, team second. So that'll send Boyce to the line where he will shoot to. His first free throws of the night. First one's up, and it's off the back of the rim. D'Angelo and Lauk checking in for the Tigers now. Boyce set for the second one, and it's up and good. So Boyce one out of two at the line in his first trip. Manny Holmes checks back in for Newson, Sin Newson. 3:04 to go. Robert C. Byrd is ahead, 24-19. Here's a near steal. Good pressure by Cam Newson showing that speed. Here's a nice play by Smith. Knocking the ball loose right to Boyce, and Boyce is the beneficiary of the good play by Smith. Nice job to jump in the air and deflect that.
Yeah, that pressure now starting to get to Elkins, causing them some problems trying to get that ball into the front court.
And Robert C. Byrd's going to take a full timeout. We'll take one along with him and be back after this. Robert C. Byrd nursing a 7-point tenuous lead here. Hasn't been the best played game by both teams or by either team so far tonight. A little bit of sloppy play. They may be able to clean that up in the second half, both teams. Here's a baseball pass, and Holland's going to run it down. Now he's going to be trapped immediately, and Nusson knocks it loose. Boyce gets the ball, and he's going to drive in. Can't get it to go. Rebound Smith. He puts the ball up. No good. Left it short. Tigers control, and they'll push the ball down four. Here's Heinzman getting to the basket. Nifty little move. Can't get it to go. Rebound Cam Nusson. Ahead to Chris Smith. It's a track meet now. Out to Boyce. He'll take a three. It's blocked. Gets his own rebound. Holmes has it. Puts the ball on the floor. Now here is a drive by Dickerson, and he's going to draw a foul going to the basket. 32 is going to be whistled for the foul. That's Donald Lauk, his first, team third.
Right now there's a lid on the basket for both teams.
Yeah. Not a shooting foul, so Robert C. Byrd will inbound the ball. Here's Manny Holmes with a wide open three. They didn't guard him, not sure why, but he drains the three. And now Elkins is going to call another timeout. So not sure why they left him open, but they had a defender there, but the defender just ignored him.
Yeah, Manny, you can't get much more of a wide open look than that. So he was almost too wide open.
Yeah, yeah. All right, let's take another timeout as the Tigers are going to take a full timeout. We'll be back. Robert C. Byrd has opened up a 12-point lead, 29-17 here at the Birdcage.
Yeah, and it's really been based off their defense here. You know, they only forced Elkins into one turnover in the first quarter, but since then have had Elkins commit six in this second quarter.
So the turnovers being forced aplenty by the Flying Eagles. Here's Chris Smith guarding number five, Wanless, doing a nice job, keeping his hands where the ref can see him, staying right with him. Loses the ball temporarily, regains control. Here is Holland with the drive. Off the backboard. Just got going too fast and missed it. Rebound, I believe that was Dickerson. Here's Holmes with the drive. He'll kick it to Nusson. Riley Dickerson will now step in, drive to the bucket, puts a shot up. Don't know how he got that to go, but it went right in the bucket.
Riley Dickerson muscled that one in.
Yeah, he did. You're right. It wasn't pretty, but he muscled it. So good determination there by Dickerson, who apparently wasn't injured at all in the Bridgeport game Friday. He may have just been scared, but thankful that he's okay. Here are the Tigers trying to get something going. Had tough luck of it the last few times down on the offensive possession. So Smith is going to pick up his second foul.
And that's now both point guards for the Flying Eagles. Junior Smith and Anthony Barbario both have two fouls so far in this contest.
So that'll force Coach Lucas to bring Levi Cochran in off the bench. Here's a pass inside to number 32, Lauk. He can't convert. Rebound, Manny Holmes. So at the half, we just have a score update. Lincoln is up 27-15 against Liberty. So the away team winning that game at the half. We'll keep you posted with further updates in the second half of our game.
course, the way Liberty shoots the three, that 12-point deficit.
Yeah.
It's only four possessions.
Yeah. And, again, you live and die by the three. So, right now they're dying by the three. They want to live by the three, definitely. So as we're talking about that other game, Coach Lucas doesn't see something he likes. He's going to call a quick timeout. They're up 31-17, 18 seconds to go. It's a 30-second timeout. We'll keep it right here. So once again, if the way things stand right now score-wise, if they hold up, I think that's what I'm trying to say, then Lincoln will play at Robert C. Byrd on Friday night. And, of course, if that happens, we'll be here to bring you all the action on the RCBSN network, the Robert C. Byrd Sports Network, where you're always on the Eagle. So, Robert C. Byrd will inbound the ball. Dickerson looking to throw the ball in. He'll get it into Anthony Barbario. And now Coach Lucas has set something up. We'll see what they run. Here's a handoff to Holmes. Over to Boyce. To Dickerson. 7 seconds. Trying to get Boyce on a screen. He's got a wide open lane. Drives down the lane. Left the layup short. Tried to shoot that as a layup and probably should have shot it as a push shot or a jump shot. So Elkins gets lucky there.
Yeah, that was a great design play out of the timeout by Coach Lucas.
Yeah. Yeah. So Robert C. Byrd's going to take a 31-17 halftime lead into the locker room. And we'll be back with the third quarter action after this.
County Schools has a long-standing tradition of providing outstanding educational opportunities for its students. Comprised of 24 schools, our district serves the needs of pre-K through 12th grade students throughout Harrison County. Providing a safe, supportive learning environment for all, we offer a well-planned, comprehensive curriculum designed to meet the needs of every student at every grade level. The elementary curriculum emphasizes core subjects augmented by music, art, health, integrated technology offerings, and physical education. Middle school students are introduced to programs, career counseling, and coursework that will help them make the transition to high school. Our high schools offer a broad and challenging curriculum to meet diversified needs and prepare our students for future careers or post-secondary education. Advanced placement honors, as well as dual credit partnerships, are available through local universities. Healthy Grand Families is a free initiative to provide information and resources to grandparents who are raising grandchildren. Healthy Grand Families is a partnership with Harrison County Schools, Family Services of Harrison County, and United Way. Harrison County Schools, where all are leaders and all are learners. Thank you.
Welcome back inside the Birdcage. 31-17. The Flying Eagles on top here tonight. This is a win or go home game, Jonathan. And as we have been checking scores at halftime, it's a tight one over at the packed Liberty Gymnasium as Lincoln took a early first half lead, but now Liberty has cut into that lead. Last time we checked, it was 22-29. Lincoln was still ahead.
Yeah, and I would be shocked. We talked during halftime. I would be shocked. And Liberty's already made somewhat of a run.
Yeah.
If they don't pull within closer, because the way they shot the ball here, and this isn't the most friendly shooting gym.
Right.
For shooters, but they can straight stroke it.
So we'll keep an eye on that game. David Oliverio, our producer, in studio. Maybe eventually, who knows? Will. Keep us updated. He's watching that game on another network for us. So just about ready to get things going. Elkins will inbound the ball. Robert C. Byrd still in their man-to-man defense. And we'll see if Elkins can run some offense, cut into this lead, and make this a close game.
Yeah,
here's a drive. Go ahead.
Defensively, Robert C. Byrd held Elkins just five points in that second quarter.
And here's a drive by Boggs. So good patience on the first opening possession for the Tigers. He draws the foul, and he'll go to the line. That's going to be on Dickerson, his second, team first. Boggs, one of two at the line tonight.
And Boggs got going early there for Elkins. Been somewhat quiet since then.
He had five early. No, actually, he had three early opening points. Seems like he scored more, though.
Yeah.
But only with 3 points. And second one's up and good. Two of two at the line tonight. 4 points on the night for Boggs. Here's a pass breaking the press. Holmes in the corner. It's a three. It's good. So Holmes starting to really stroke it now for the Flying Eagles late in the season.
And again, that's another wide open look for Manny Holmes, just standing there on an island by himself in the corner. Easy catch and shoot.
And that's what you want to try to do if you're if you're being pressed. You want to try to find open shots, threes or open layups. And if the defense doesn't get back, then they're there. Here's a drive and a kick out to Boggs. He'll set the offense. Now he's going to try to get to the basket. Puts a shot up. No good. Tapped out to Carson Bennett. Or Carson Bennett taps it out. And Wandless regains control, but he takes a step and a jump hop. And he's going to be called for the walk.
Yeah, that man-to-man defense right now is causing some fits for the guards for the Elkins Tigers.
Lucas D'Angelo, the only one for the Tigers, is wearing matching shoes tonight. He's got orange shoes on to match his uniform. Holmes with another three. This time it's no good, and he instantly commits I didn't hit the shot foul, or whatever you want to call it. Just couldn't help but reaching in. Only his second, though. Team second. And quietly, Robert C. Byrd's built a 16-point lead, Jonathan, so they're in control right now.
Yeah, and it's all really started and been predicated off of that defensive pressure. It's lead some easy runouts and some easy baskets. And if you're the Flying Eagles, a young team, we've talked on it all year, the best thing to do is trying to score before the defense gets set.
And now the Tigers are going to be called for a five-second call. Not even sure they were really trying to get that five-second call. I think it was just more indecision on part of Elkins.
And that's two quick turnovers in this third quarter. Nine for the game so far committed by the Tigers.
Here's Carson Bennett with a nice little wheel around. Hook shot, can't get it to go. If he ever gets that hook shot and can get it reliable, then he's going to be a force to be reckoned with. Going to be much better. Dickerson with the trip, he's going to pick up another foul. That's his third, team third.
And we've talked all night about how good the pressure defense has been by the Flying Eagles so far tonight, but they have just picked up their third team foul here in this third quarter. And the one thing you don't want to do is put Elkins in the bonus for them to be at the free throw line with the clock stopped.
Right, right. Here's another drive by Juan. This nice job muscling his way to the basket. Again, that wasn't pretty, but it was effective.
It's his first 2 points of the game.
Here's a pass inside to Carson Bennett. Kicks it out to Barberio. He'll line up a three, and it's good for Barberio. His first three of the night. Here is Holland with a three. No good. Rebound Griffin. He can't get it to go. And it's going to be out of bounds on number five, Wanless. And the Eagles will take control. Elkins in full court pressure. Zone 1-2-2. Robert Seabird breaks the press. And now the ball is stripped by Wanless. He's going to drive down, and he's going to lay the bucket in. So nice job by Wanless, coast to coast.
Yeah, it's good being active by Wanless with his hand in the passing lane.
Here's a near steal. Boys controls. He's going to drive to the bucket, and he puts a shot up, and he's going to be fouled hard by Griffin Boggs. His second, team first. So another score update from Liberty High School. Lincoln 35, Liberty 31. 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. So Lincoln has surrendered a little bit of that point margin, that lead there.
And we saw both of those teams here at the Birdcage. And from the games we saw, you know, I thought Liberty was the better team.
Yeah. They don't have the height, but they make up for that three-point shooting and guard play. So Boyce at the line, he misses his first. Second shot's up, and this is good. Here's Friedman bringing the ball up against Barberio, number 11 against number 11. Good job by Barberio to move his feet. And you see, when the Eagles want to play defense, they can.
Yeah, that their defense and their on-ball defense has been really, really good tonight.
And here's a foul. It's going to be called against Boyce. That's Boyce's first foul tonight, team fourth. And that's going to put Griffin Boggs at the line, where he's 2-for-2 tonight. And he airballs the first one, I believe. It just skimmed the net. So he'll get the second one. It's up and it's good. So 3-of-6 tonight at the line for Griffin Boggs for the Tigers. Here's a knockdown pass, and Tigers are going to get a handle on it, or a hand on it, I should say. Nearly stolen by Friedman, but he has the ball go out of bounds off his hand.
And that was just somewhat of a lazy pass by the Flying Eagles.
Yeah.
Fortunate that it went out of bounds and wasn't a turnover.
Coach Lucas telling them to throw the ball with more authority, throw it over their head if they need to. Here's Boyce at the top of the key. And Robert Seabird just running offense now, trying to get a good shot. Elkins in a 2-3 zone still. Here's Holmes on the wing, another three. So Holmes has looked really good shooting the three ball tonight. That's his fourth one, Jonathan.
Yeah, really good job, good penetration, finding Holmes. He's had the hot hand from deep here tonight.
And if you can get two deep threats going in the form of Holmes and Boyce, then that really bodes well for you in this game and going into the rest of the postseason.
Yeah, man, he's got 12 points all from deep.
There's a nice cut by D'Angelo and a nice pass by Griffin Boggs. And D'Angelo is going to get the bucket, his first 2 points of the night. Here's a deep three by Nusson, no good. Ball bounces out to Holland, and the Tigers control. Here's another three short by Heinzman. Rebound, Robert C. Byrd ahead to Newsong. Great leading pass by Barbario. Newsong can't get it to go, but Boyce drives in the garbage truck, picks it up, and puts it in.
Yeah, and again, that's good hustle there by Boyce, not giving up, because right. It looked like it was going to be an easy layup. He didn't give up, got the rebound, and got put back.
So the Eagles, or I should say the Tigers take a timeout. We'll take one along with them. Back inside the Byrd case, Robert C. Byrd in control, 43-25, 2:55 to go in the third quarter. Elkins is going to inbound the ball, but they can't find anybody to inbound it right now. So,
a good drive there by D'Angelo.
His second bucket of the night. 43-27. And our athletic director, Eric Post, has just informed us that the next game, the sectional game, whoever we play or whenever it's played, will be Thursday night. It was posted on Metro News, or it was on the Metro News website, I believe, as being listed on Friday. But it is indeed on Thursday night. And we'll run over those scenarios with you again here at the end of the quarter. So Robert C. Byrd just running some clock now, running their offense. Griffin Boggs, his third, team third. So good opportunity for the Eagles and Coach Lucas to practice your offense, get live practice situation. You're in control right here.
Yeah, you want to run some stuff with this lead and work on some stuff in live game action that, you know, you may want to clean up, or this scenario or that, because, you know, again, it's very fortunate to be able to do that in a live game.
Yeah. Here's Carson, high post, extended, actually the top of the key. Boyce puts the ball on the floor. Nice cut by Holmes, but Boyce couldn't get it to him. And ball's on the floor. And it's going to be we're going to have a foul. I'm not sure I saw that one, but they call the foul on Bennett, I believe. His first, team fifth. So the Tigers will go to the line now. I hear my southern accent when I say Tigers.
And again, what we talked about, you know, that pressure defense, you're going to somewhat commit more fouls.
Yeah.
That's the fifth foul, so the Eagles are going to put the Tigers at the line here.
So Heinzman's first trip to the line tonight. Shots up, and it bounces out. It was long. He'll get the second one.
Good news is there's only a minute 35 in this third, so.
Yeah. Better than 3:35 or 4:35. Second shot by Heinzman is good.
Heinzman's fourth point of the ball game for the Tigers.
Elkins still in that man-to-man pressure. Well, I should say full-court zone trap pressure. And here's a three by Boyce with a guy right in his face. No problem. His third three of the night. So Elkins makes a little run, and then Robert C. Byrd responds.
Yeah, Elkins has done much better off in the offensive half court in this third quarter. They just can't get stops.
So here's Boggs with a nice drive. Left of the basket, puts a shot up with his right hand, and maybe he should have been doing that more tonight, because that was really nice. 54 seconds to go, 46-30. Robert C. Byrd in control. Elkins is going to try to trap this ball, get a turnover. Robert C. Byrd doing a good job. And here's a three by Holmes. Good-looking three. No problem for Holmes. His fifth three of the night, doing his damage from behind the arc. 21 seconds to go. 19-point lead for the Flying Eagles.
Holmes has let it fly here tonight, and it has fallen for Manny.
And he might have the green light because there was time running down in the quarter, and you usually don't want to take a three-point shot, but he has been on tonight, so Coach Lucas must have said, go right ahead, sir. Here's a shot by the Tigers. No good at the end of the third quarter. And your Flying Eagles are going to go into the fourth quarter of this make it or break it game. Win or lose, win or go home. Fourth quarter. We'll be back after this. Back inside the bird cage, student section not alive, but they're here. They're just lamenting all the homework they're going to have to stay up tonight doing. So, 49-30. So we want to remind you of the scenario. Again, the next sectional game will be this Thursday. That will be the sectional championship. If Robert C. Byrd and Liberty win, well, let's say if Robert C. Byrd and Lincoln win, because Lincoln was winning the last time we checked, that game will be here Thursday night because we are the higher seed. Robert C. Byrd is the higher seed. If Robert C. Byrd wins, which it looks like they will, and Liberty wins, then that game will be at Liberty on Thursday night because they are the higher seed.
So right now a scenario is if this score holds, it looks like Robert C. Byrd's either going to be hosting or playing at Liberty.
Yes. Here's Boyce with a nice drive, no problem. And he lays it in for two.
Good look.
Yeah, and actually, those are the only two scenarios that are possible now that I think about it. Because we're already playing Elkins, and we can't play ourselves. So sometimes it seems like we're battling ourselves, though. So they call a foul on, we'll have to check that. Team first, we know that.
That was on Junior Smith, his third.
So Smith snuck into the game when I was talking about playoff scenarios, and he does pick up his third. Rebound Boyce back down court to Holmes. Holmes will back it out. He's thinking about another three. I know he is. And we're going to have a foul on Boggs trying to make a play. I believe, no, that is actually going to be on Wanless, his third, team first. So Junior Smith has a lot of classes in my hallway. He's just a fun kid to watch. I see the other kids. I see Riley and Manny from time to time. Logan Boyce. Don't see Manny that, or don't see Sin Noose on that much. Here's Holmes. He can't be stopped. That's a two-pointer from inside the three-point line. So really feeling it. And you notice he's got much better arc on his shot tonight.
Yeah, his shot is much more arc, and it's a pretty-looking shot here tonight.
And here's a nice block by Holmes. So he's just having his way. Assist to Chris Smith. I'm going to call him Chris. I've got that in my mind now. That's his real name. He doesn't want to be called by that. But it's Junior. It's Christopher Smith Jr., but it's Junior Smith. So too bad for Holmes. He's going to get an assist if Smith makes one of these free throws. So he had a bucket, had a rebound, then an assist. So Junior Smith's got to hit this next one in order for Holmes to get the assist. That would be a shot, a rebound, an assist all inside of, what, 10 seconds, 10, 15 seconds? Smith set for the second one, and it is good. So I'll have to relay that story to them tomorrow morning. I'm sure they'll be just so happy to hear me say it. .54-30, 24-point lead, 6:30 to go at the Birdcage. Elkins came in here, started the game out well. You know, looked like they were going to challenge, but slowly Robert C. Byrd has just applied that pressure and built this lead.
Yeah, Elkins got off to that 5-0 start early and looked like they were going to be in control. And Robert C. Byrd said, not so fast.
Here's Boggs putting the ball on the floor. Can't get that shot to go. Good job by Holmes to pressure. Robert C. Byrd up floor. Here's Boyce. I'm tripping on all sorts of wires. And Logan Boyce puts another two-point in. So Boyce and Holmes doing the bulk of the work tonight for the Flying Eagles. 56-30, 5:51 to go. We'll take a break and be back after this. Back to live action here, just discussing future plans for the RCBSN. Elkins trying to mount any bit of a comeback here, but it's not looking good for the Tigers right now. Here's Boggs with another drive, left side, puts a shot up with his right hand, no good. Just not enough in the gas tank for Boggs and the Tigers tonight.
And that's that same move that Boggs scored on earlier with his left. That time he shot it with his right.
Yeah. So you said it during the break, Holmes and Boyce doing the damage tonight.
Yeah,
Jonathan.
Boyce 21 points, Manny Holmes 17 points. Boyce has three made threes, Manny's got five.
And Levi Cochran's got two off the bench, the sophomore with a nice shot in the lane.
And we saw Cochran play some crucial minutes in that nail biter against Bridgeport and held his own.
And here's a drive by Wanless. Foul's going to be on Cochran. So he's got a bucket and a foul. Good work.
And if you're Coach Lucas in this Robert C. Byrd coaching staff, I mean, you're young as a whole, but your guards, your point guards are really young. Barbario, a sophomore, Cochran, a sophomore, and then Junior Smith, a freshman.
Wanless misses the first. And it's not that bad of an idea for a young player like Cochran to get in there and get a foul, take a foul. You're not trying to hurt anybody, but, you know, you want them to get used to fouling. If you need to foul at the end of the game to know what it's like. Here are the Tigers with the rebound. Cochran can't convert on that layup. Just over 4 minutes to go, 58-31. Flying Eagles flying high tonight. Here's a deep three by Holland to no good. Rebound Eagles. And it's knocked out of there, controlled by the Tigers. Here's Boggs in the corner. And a deep three off to the right by D'Angelo. Put back by number 23, Holland. His second two-pointer of the night. Has 1 3-pointer to go along with that.
Yeah, and that's Holland's just his 2 points in this second half. He got off to a quick start in that first half. Had five quick points.
Yeah.
It's been somewhat contained here.
Yeah. Here's a nice drive. Euro step by Wanless. Sin-Nu Song with the drive. Kicks out to Dickerson. And Smith will hold at the top of the key, waiting on instructions from Coach Lucas, Coach Noble. Robbie C. Burgess taking their time. Just over 3 minutes to go, and Robert C. Byrd just looking to maybe pass and dribble this out. And they're going to make Elkins come out and get them. They come out in a trap, and foul's going to be committed by number two. That's D'Angelo, his second, team second. 3 minutes to go. And Robert C. Byrd gets the ball inbounds. Nice pass to Sin-Nu Song. Passed up the shot. And Robert C. Byrd not really looking to even score here right now.
Yeah, just trying to run some offense and run clock.
There's a foul by number three, Caleb Ray, his second, team third. So with 20 seconds to go in the game, Lincoln is up on Liberty 50-45. So if that holds true, then we'll be back here Thursday night against Lincoln. .230 to go. Smith with the handles. Just fun to watch Smith play.
Yeah, he plays with an intensity at all times.
And now the Tigers are going to empty their bench here. Get some of those subs in. And now Chris Smith throws the ball away, misdirection. Thought the player was going to cut to the right, but he cuts the other way. .207 to go, 58-35. Eagles looking to close this one out and play another game this week in the sectional tournament.
Yeah, quick turnaround, just one day off and then back at it.
But that's probably the way you like it at this time of year. You want to play. You don't want to practice. You want to practice, but, you know, you'd rather play if you can because those games are so limited.
Yeah, I know if you're a player, you don't.
Yeah, players don't like to practice.
This point of the season, let's play.
Let's play, yeah. And if they win tonight and then they end up winning Thursday night, then they'll have ample time to practice. Tomorrow will be a good day to come in and just work on things, set things straight, look ahead to the opponent Thursday night, whoever that may be, get ready for them. Here is Elijah Chips off the bench, number 22, for his first points of the night in the form of a three, 61-35, just over a minute to go here. And it looks like the Eagles are going to move on to the next round of the sectional tournament. That will be in the sectional championship game, either here or at Liberty. And we're just waiting on that Liberty score now. There's a nice-looking three by number 33, Matt Mahoney. Where's that been all night? Youngster smiling about that bucket.
Yeah, good-looking shot for the big man.
Yeah. 61-38, 30 seconds to go here. Good for these younger players on both teams to get playing time. Even though Elkins' season is going to be over, these kids have put in a lot of hard work, a lot of practice time during this year, and they want to be rewarded with a little bit of playing time, so it's good for them. 10 seconds to go. Here is Sin Nusson getting a late bucket. His third point of the night. And that's just going to do it. Elkins heaves a shot at the buzzer. No good. And Robert C. Byrd's going to win it by a score of 63-38. So that's going to end Elkins' season. They're going to fall and finish the season at 5-18. Robert C. Byrd's going to improve to 10-12. We'll take a quick break and be back after this. So back at the birdcage where the Eagles fly out of the nest and they take care of the Tigers tonight by a score of 63-38. They move on to the sectional championship game, which is going to be Thursday night, and we now know that that game is going to be here at the birdcage because Lincoln has defeated Liberty by a score of 54-48, Coach Lucas. Certainly that's got to be semi-good news.
Well, I mean, you want to put yourself in a position – you want to put yourself in a position to be able to play at home, and that's what we've done. You know, with the way the situation, the way the system was set up this year, you know, we went 2-1, and Liberty went 2-1, And, you know, unfortunately our loss was to Liberty, so they got the one seed, and when we got the two, with Liberty getting beat now as the one seed, we're the two seed. So Lincoln, who was the four seed, is now coming here to play on Thursday. And we're excited to be able to host a game, you know, here in the Birdcage.
It's sort of bittersweet, I imagine, because you're competitive, and I know you would have liked to have another shot at Liberty, but you also want to play at home.
Absolutely. In all honesty, it didn't matter who won that game. You know, we're just happy. You know, this is a really young team. You're watching them grow up in front of your eyes. And I told them, you know, when we were starting to prepare for sectional time, how amazing it was, you know, going to Logan that first game and not really being able to run any offense, not really being able to run any press offense. And then watching them today, it's a testament to how hard these kids work and how much they bought into each other.
Yeah.
You know, that's the key. When, you know, I know they're going to be good when it's all said and done because they care for each other. And when that happens, when you get a unit that doesn't care what's going on, they're sharing the ball, they're cheering each other on, they're telling each other they love you. That's a great atmosphere to work in every day, I promise you.
So let's talk about tonight's game just a little bit. Elkins came in here. They were game early on, raced out to a 5-0 lead. But after that, you all were able to slowly build a lead. And me and Jonathan looked up, and it was a 20-point lead before we knew it, thanks to Logan Boyce, who finished with 21, and Manny Holmes, who had 15. But they were all on 5 3-point shots, and I don't think he missed a 3-point shot tonight either.
I tell you what, that's what I've been saying all year long. When you can take a team and you can space guys out on the floor, you know, and it's this simple. For the season, for the 21 game season, Logan Boyce set the school record from 3-point range at 46%. Manny Holmes tied the school record with Luke Dyer at number 2 at 42%. Now I don't know how many. I've been coaching over here for 12 years. I don't know how many teams had two sophomores on the floor that were shooting over 40% for 3-point range from the season. So, when you can do that, you know, we got other guys who can score. Cam's had a nice year as well. So, we've got one guy in double figures, two guys at 9 points apiece for the season, and you can space the floor that well. It's hard to shut off one side then.
It is.
And we've had teams where, you know, we only had two scores, and it's difficult to score when it's like that.
That's the thing that we're excited about, myself and Jonathan, is the fact that these sophomores are going to be juniors next year. And you mentioned those two players. But also off the bench, Chris Smith just brings unlimited energy sometimes.
Well, you know, junior's a defender, and that's exactly what he does. He makes that other point guard miserable. You know, I wanted to point out, you know, when Barb's on the floor, Barb's playing tremendous on-ball defense.
Yes, he did.
Okay? So he's playing tremendous on-ball defense. Carson's in the rebound and screening for guys, getting guys open. They're supposed to be making good passes all the time. So that's what I'm talking about when a team's working together. And you can see defensively, I mean, we're better than any other point than we've been all season.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
So just communication and everything. So now let's get into junior. Now you're going to bring junior in. Now that point guard thinks he's going to break. Hey, we're bringing the freshman in here. You're not getting a break.
Right.
You're not getting a break because he's ready to go and he's going to get in your grill.
Exactly.
You know, and Cam hasn't been started, so you need to bring Cam in who can score. That's another, you know, his first basket of the night tonight was a layup because that's what happens. You know, they lose him, boom, he's gone. I can't say enough about it. Our bench is built. Went from a 7-man bench to a 9-person bench right now. The minutes
so
that Levi
important.
Cochran has given us the last couple games has been tremendous. He's earned my trust. Watching him compete in practice every day against the varsity, and then putting him in games where he's just doing nothing but making great decisions. We're running motion offense. They're reading. He sets a tremendous flare screen. They chase the shooter. He drops in the middle, gets the ball right in front of the basket. That's the way it's supposed to work.
Yeah. Yeah. Very good. Well, Coach, congratulations on tonight's win. We'll let you go and talk to your team, talk to your wife. I see she's waiting down there for you.
Well, she missed her kiss tonight. I told her two times. I said, Tina, the game starts at 7. But I think she was on 7:30 mode because I didn't see her. And I was getting a little bit nervous. But I had to wait till halftime to get that kiss before the game.
Okay, Coach. Well, thanks for stopping by. Once again, congratulations and good luck Thursday night. We'll see you then.
Hey, thank you so much, guys. I appreciate everything you guys are doing. I mean that.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, let's take a look at a couple of the stats with Jonathan.
Yeah, real quick look at the stats here. Individually, Elkins, they were led by Griffin Boggs. He finished with 7 points, 4 assists, and 3 rebounds. Brock Holland also had 7 points and 5 rebounds. Dylan Heinzman finished with 4 points and 1 assist. Levi Wanless finished with two rebounds and 7 points. Taking a look at the Flying Eagles, what a game. It was really a two-man game here tonight offensively. Logan Boyce, game high, 21 points, 3 rebounds, 5 assists. And then Manny Holmes, who was perfect from deep tonight, finished with 17 points, 2 assists, 3 rebounds. Also, Anthony Barbario finished with 5 points and 2 rebounds. Cam Newson came off the bench. Really like him coming off the bench, as Coach Lucas said. Gives you that scoring option off the bench. He finished with 4 points, 1 assist, 3 rebounds. Carson Bennett had 2 rebounds, 1 assist, and 3 points. Riley Dickerson had 5 rebounds, 1 assist, 4 points. Junior Smith, 3 rebounds, 1 point. Sin Newson, 2 rebounds, 3 points. And Levi Cochran had 2 points, 1 assist for the Flying Eagles tonight.
So, once again, reminding you that the Flying Eagles win 63-38 over the Tigers here. We wish the Tigers a safe trip back to Elkins. And don't forget, the sectional championship game will be at Robert C. Byrd this Thursday night at 7 o'clock. Robert C. Byrd will be facing the Lincoln Cougars for the third time this year. They split with them in the season. Each team won at home. And again, that game will be at 7 o'clock, and we'll be here on the RCBSN network to bring you all the action. We're going to wrap it up right now and get home, get some sleep, and get ready to go to work tomorrow. I want to thank once again our wonderful producer, David Oliverio. I thought this might be our last night together, but we're going to get one more night this Thursday. So for myself and Jonathan Griffin, I'm saying goodnight, Doss.
Goodnight, Josiah.
And goodnight, everyone.
It's a Robert C. Byrd touchdown.